Namaste to all. Myself, Dr. Vidyashri, PhD scholar at Espasa, deemed to be university. I firstly thank all the organizers for providing me opportunity to present in the platform. I hereby present my pilot study on cerebrovascular hemodynamic responses in type 2 diabetes mellitus following yoga intervention under the guidance of Dr. Deepeshwar Singh, Dr. Vijay Sharma, and Dr. Lokesh Patel. Type 2 diabetes mellitus is one of the most commonly occurring non-communicable disorders. Yoga practices are proven to improve the glycemic index in the patients who are suffering from type 2 diabetes mellitus by controlling their blood sugar level. Whereas less studies have been done in the field where the complications of diabetes mellitus. One of the most important pathological changes that may happen in type 2 diabetes mellitus is a lowering of the cerebrovascular reactivity in the brain. The body has its own mechanism of regulating the blood flow to the brain, and which has been found compromised in type 2 diabetes mellitus. This can be attributed to the stiffness of the arteries because of the endothelial dysfunctioning of the arteries. And there are a few studies which in yoga field which have proven that yoga practices may help in improving the hemodynamics, especially in healthy population. But there are no studies conducted on the participants or the subjects who are suffering from type 2 diabetes mellitus or hypertension where the cerebrovascular hemodynamics have been compromised. So with this background, we aim to explore the effect of yoga on cerebrovascular hemodynamics changes in middle cerebral arteries. And the objectives of our studies were to study the effect of yoga in type 2 diabetes mellitus on blood flow velocity and also flow resistance in middle cerebral artery. We hypothesized that yoga practices may improve the blood flow velocity and reduce the flow resistance of middle cerebral artery in type 2 diabetes mellitus. So 10 participants were recruited from our holistic health center, Arogyadhama, Espasa. The inclusion criteria were the patient should be diagnosed with type 2 diabetes under the guidelines of American Diabetes Association 2018, and they should be aged between 35 to 65 years. And the exclusions were all the complications related to diabetes mellitus, such as nephropathy, retinopathy, and neuropathy were excluded. And if they were suffering from any obesity, they were excluded. And if they have any history of drug abuse, and also if they are suffering from any psychological conditions, they were excluded from the studies. And if they are on any medications, basically which impact on the cerebral hemodynamics, even they were excluded. And if they are suffering from any cerebrovascular diseases such as stroke, even those participants were excluded from the study. So basically, it was a single group pre-post study with 7 days of integrated approach of yoga therapy intervention, which included type 2 diabetes specific yoga protocol and also meditation classes, pranayama classes, counseling, and also lecturing sessions. The variables we studied were peak systolic velocity, mean flow velocity, the pulsatility index, and also resistance index. And for screening, to exclude them from any psychological condition, we used symptom checklist 90R, and to measure all the variables, we used the tool transcranial Doppler. So transcranial Doppler, it is basically a non-invasive technique of measuring the blood flow velocity. It basically works on the principle of the Doppler shift. Here we had used the probe of 2 megahertz, and initially we had raised the acoustic window near the temporal region of the patient, and the middle cerebral artery was assessed using that acoustic window between the depth of 40 to 64 millimeter. And the data was collected on first as well as the last day, that is on the 7th day of the intervention. And we used SPSS version 23 to analyze the data. And these are the results found of the pilot study. We did not find any much a statistically significant result in any of the variables. But if we look at the trend here in the graphs, we can see there was much improvement in the blood flow velocity. The trend was positive in nature, especially. the mean blood flow velocity on the second graph, the mean blood flow velocity to the brain was found to be increasing. And also the resistance index, which is calculated using the pulsatility index and also the resistance index. These two indexes were found to be reducing after 1 week of yoga intervention. So this study showed us some good trend in improving the cerebral hemodynamics, even in cases of type 2 diabetes mellitus. It showed us the improvement in the blood flow velocity to the brain, especially to the frontal lobe through the middle cerebral artery, and reduction in the resistance level on the arterial wall in type 2 diabetes mellitus. The problem in mechanism of action for these changes which are happening with a short span is, like, the yoga has its impact on autonomic nervous system, and even the cerebral blood flow is found to be regulated by autonomic nervous system by altering the tone of the artery. And one more important mechanism is our yoga practices are known to cause hypoxia and also hypercapnia, especially the pranayama practices such as kumbhaka is known to cause hypoxia, and practices such as kapalabhati and bhastrika are known to cause hypercapnia. These hypoxia and hypercapnia are known to influence the cerebral blood flow. So hence both these changes might have happened. And lastly, of course, the yoga helps in reducing the stress by bringing about balance in hypothalamus pituitary adrenal axis. So these are the probable mechanism how the yoga is helping in this condition. So henceforth, we conclude that even with pilot study of 7 days of intervention, there was some positive results which were happening in with respect to the cerebral hemodynamics in type 2 diabetes mellitus patients. And there is requirement for further extensive randomized study in this subject with longer intervention period and also with a bigger sample size. And this study is under progress now. These are the few references used. Thank you all.